Hello everyone, welcome back to the Multiverse. Before we start, please don't forget to subscribe if you don't want to miss the next videos. Today we are talking about nilpotent matrices. So let's start with the first definition. A nilpotent matrix is a square matrix A of order m, for example, such that there exists a positive integer n, such that A to the power of n is equal to 0, where 0 denotes, of course, the 0 matrix of order m. So now, what is the nilpotency index of a nilpotent matrix? Whenever we have a nilpotent matrix, okay, we have seen by definition that there exists an integer n such that A to the n is equal to 0. Okay, but it may not be the smallest. So the nilpotency index is the smallest integer such that A to the n is equal to 0. You can also call it index or degree. What does a power of A mean? This we are going to see with the next example, which is the first example of the day. Let's start with a very simple matrix, a 2 times 2 square matrix, whose entries are 2, minus 1, 4, and minus 2, as you see. I claim that this matrix is nilpotent. I do more than claiming because we are now going to prove it. Let's start with A square. A square, as we said, it's simply A times A. If you don't remember what is the multiplication of two matrices, don't worry because we already studied this subject in a previous video. I'm going to post the link in the description below, so you will be able to click and check. So here we are going to perform this multiplication, A times A, and the result is easily seen to be the matrix 0, 0, 0, 0, the 0 matrix of order 2 times 2. But let me help you with one computation. We are doing the first, we are computing this. So if you don't remember now, I'm just repeating for the sake of the watchers. We take the first row of the left matrix and the first column of the right matrix. And then we do this computation. It will be 2 times 2 plus minus 1 times 4. Okay, the reason is the following. You take 2 times 2, the first elements of respectively the first row and the first column, and then you consider the multiplication of the second elements of the first row and first column. Okay, what you obtain is clearly 0. 4 minus 4 is 0. You repeat the same computation for the other rows and columns, and you will obtain 0, 0 in all the matrices. Now, that means that not only our matrix A square is the zero matrix, that also means that the nilpotency index of the matrix A is equal to 2. Let's go with a bigger example, in the sense that our matrix now is bigger, is a 3 times 3 matrix. As you can see, this matrix contains a lot of zeros. This is very common with nilpotent matrices, as we are going to see very soon. But now let's start with this example. I claim again that the matrix B is nilpotent, and now we are going to prove it. First, again, we are going to compute B square. B square, as before, will be B times B. And B times B is nothing but this following multiplication. You can compute the multiplication. It's very easy. When there are many zeros, the computation is very easy. It's not the zero matrix, because in the position 3, 1, we actually have the number minus 15. So let's just compute this so we have it. So we need to take the third row of the left matrix and the first column of the right matrix. Like before, we multiply and sum like we did before. So it will be 4 times 0 plus minus 5 times 3 which is different from zero, plus zero times four. Okay, and this is given minus 15, which is exactly what we have here. Okay, so if b squared is not zero, that means that we still don't know if b is an Nilpotent matrix or not. So let's go to compute b cube. Okay, it's the next level, the next step that we can make. So b cube is b times b times b, but the letter can also be written as b square times b. Okay, b square we already have, we just computed, and b it's the definition, the given matrix. So let's go to compute this, and at the end you can easily see that the result of this easy multiplication is finally the zero matrix. So yes, the matrix B is nilpotent, and we know more than that. We also know that the nilpotency index of the matrix B is equal to 3. Now let's go on with a generalization. Let's go into generalize the previous example. As I said, many times with nilpotent matrices, we have a lot of zeros. Not always, but very often. So the property is the following. Every lower triangular or upper triangular matrix with only zero on the diagonal is nilpotent. Again, if you don't remember what the lower triangular and upper triangular mean, don't worry, because I'm going to post again the link of the second video where we studied exactly triangular matrices. Let's go to study the upper triangular case. And let's see how all the upper triangular nilpotent matrices are made. So here we have the matrix U, which is of course an upper triangular matrix, with a particular property that all the elements on the diagonal are all zeros, as you can see the green diagonal. This kind of matrix is always nilpotent. And now we go to the lower triangular case, which is the matrix L. And if you think about it, it's exactly the case of the example where the matrix B was lower triangular. But a particular case of lower triangular, not any lower triangular, only those lower triangular matrices whose entries in the diagonal are all zero. But what if our matrix is not nilpotent? We know that if the matrix is nilpotent, then the matrix to the power of m, where m is the order of the matrix, is equal to the zero matrix. So that means that if it is not equal to zero, then the matrix is not nilpotent. So we have a limited amount of computation to make, at most small m, the order of the matrix. That's great, because we can easily say if a matrix is nilpotent or not. Let's see it with a very easy example. We have the matrix C, 0, 1, 1, 0, a very simple example. I claim that it's not nilpotent. Let's prove it. So let's compute C squared. Again, C squared is nothing but C times C. Let's compute this. It's an easy computation. You can easily check it. The result will be 1, 0, 0, 1. It's not the matrix Z, okay, be careful, but it's not even the zero matrix. Okay, by the previous property, we know for sure that this matrix is not nilpotent, because C to the 2, and 2 is the order of the matrix C, is not the zero matrix. So our matrix is not nilpotent. Okay, it's a very powerful tool that we just described. Well, yes, of course, this matrix is, if you didn't notice, it's not the zero matrix. And here the conclusion that we already claimed, okay? Here it's written very clearly. So our matrix C is not important. That's it for today. So I'll see you in the next video. Thank you very much for watching. Please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Bye.